what we are doing right now, or we have experiments going on, they're basically fatigue experiments where the end goal is to develop the capability to monitor how physically fatigued an individual is becoming.
And we're trying to understand at what point through a kind of series of progressive exercises is our subject becoming fatigued? And at which point is their performance starting to degrade because of that fatigue?
We basically want to, using sensors that are attached to the individual, have some way of quantifying something on like an order of a scale of 1 to 10, basically determining how physically fatigued someone is as they're performing an exercise. Throughout that whole entire experiment, we're collecting this physiological and biomechanical data.
As you become fatigued, you lose things like coordination, you're more prone to lose bodily awareness, and you're more likely to become injured as a result. The original reason we kind of started this project was with the warfighter in mind, specifically kind of basic combat training.
What it means for the military in the end is a reduced incidence of musculoskeletal injuries, which makes it so that people can train longer and harder without experiencing injuries. There's applications to a athletic population.
Firefighting, jobs in factories, things like that, where you're constantly moving, performing fairly complex biomechanical movements.
The big impact that we're working towards is reducing each individual's injury risk.
I think I envision this type of research facilitating how can we get kind of elevate the layman or someone just entering a new field to this high level of performance in the least amount of time possible.
Being able to kind of have that positive impact on individuals and make it so that people can do their jobs and not have to worry about getting injured, for me, kind of brings a lot of value to kind of what I do on a day-to-day basis.